really just made me think.
Andy Reid could play a good Santa Claus.
Okay.
That'd be interesting. Let's check in with Kenny Crumpton.
Oh, wow, that sounds like a very interesting little scenario for a movie.
Oh, it's a Hallmark movie. You know, what could be better?
A Hallmark Christmas movie, yes. I mean, what could be better? You know what's going to happen.
Hallmark chink, chink. Movies.
Okay, yeah, there it is. Yeah, yeah. And they live happily ever after. Okay.
And they don't
just
kiss
like
till the end.
The Corvair,
they always wait
right
to kiss
here.
Till the end. I don't...
At the very end, because you know why? They live happily ever after. All right. Well, let's talk about the Corvair. It's having a nice little happily ever after with us here at the History Center, the Crawford Auto Museum, and the West Reserve Historical Society. All of that under one umbrella. Okay. Now, this is a four-door.
Yes.
And I wasn't familiar with the four. I remember the two-door Corvairs.
Yeah. This is a slightly later evolution. This is sort of the second series of the Corvairs that started in 1965 and went to 1969. You'll notice that the body style is now a little bit sleeker.
Okay.
It doesn't have that sort of traditional Corvair fold in the body seam.
Engine's still in the rear.
Engine's still in the rear. Yep, they were all rear engine cars. This one's a little bit more contemporary. Instead of a bench seat in the front, we've got two bucket seats now.
Okay.
And still has the sort of pseudo wire wheel covers, you know, a little bit sporty. And but this is a little bit more practical now. We've got a four door as opposed to a two door, sort of more family oriented.
Now, this one is super duper unique. They did not make many of these at all. Look at this thing.
This is a really rare car. This is the Corvair station wagon. And it's unique because it was only made for a couple of years. And it has a tremendous amount of storage in it because the engine's in the back.
Yeah, that's what these vents are for.
That's what the vents are for.
Engines are in the back.
You've got a deck lid that goes over the engine, so you've got storage there. The seats fold down, you got storage there, and because the engine's in the back, you've got a whole trunk.
Your trunk
is in the front.
Front. So we that's even more storage.
It's called a frunk.
A frunk. Wow, because that's where the engine would be. You know, you have to remind yourself, even though they have a place where the engine would be, that's not where it is.
That's correct.
Now, this is super duper rare.
It is.
Was this a precursor for anything, do you think?
Not really. It was kind of a one-off thing. There was nothing that really followed it. It wasn't really all that popular.
Okay.
For whatever reason, it just never really took off. So it was only made for a couple of years. And because it was a utilitarian vehicle and, you know, not so highly regarded back in the day, there's not many of them left. And to have one in this condition right now is cool.
All right, tomorrow, big Corvair cruising event.
Yes, sir, from 4 o'clock to 8 o'clock right here at the Crawford Auto Aviation Museum.
Okay.
Corvairs, 60s cars, other collector cars, whoever wants to come. We're gonna have lectures about 60s culture, music, Corvair history, fashion. All kinds of good stuff.
All kinds of good stuff. But we're not wearing any dresses this morning. I'll tell you that right now, John. Not happening. I don't care how bad we want to promote that. Not happening. Okay, when we come back, two more really unique Corvairs and one that you've never seen before. I guarantee you they have it right here. All right,
love
back
that.
To you guys.
Love the two-door and the four-door there, too.
Very nice.